Welcome to the final part of this series about the uniform polyhedra, and I've saved the best till last. We've covered 45 polyhedra so far. This part will cover the remaining 8, the most complicated ones, the monster snubs. We'll start with the snub Icosidodecadodecahedron. Let's look at just the faces around a single vertex. I've left the edges in place purely to show the sheer complexity of the structure. This has 6 faces around the vertex, which is typical of a snub. 3 main faces, separated by so-called snub triangles. In this case, the non-snub faces are a triangle, a pentagon, and a pentagram. For the rest of this video, I'll always colour snub triangles in yellow and non-snub faces in another colour. The 2 snub triangles next to the pentagram intersect each other, so the pentagram sits above them. If we walk clockwise around the vertex, we cross a pentagon, a snub triangle, a triangle, and a snub triangle. But when we cross the pentagram, we're actually going anti-clockwise, before finally going clockwise across the last snub triangle. The pentagram is reversed, or upside down. This can be seen more clearly if we remove the top of the vertex and look at the vertex figure. The sequence of faces around each vertex is known as the vertex configuration, and is written, in this case, 5-3-3-3-5-over-3-3. This is normally abbreviated to this. Note that the pentagram appears as 5-over-3, which is a reversed 5-over-2. This vertex is not mirror symmetric. It has triangle, pentagram, pentagon in clockwise order. In practice, this means the polyhedron as a whole is chiral. Its mirror reflection has the same faces, but in anti-clockwise order. To better understand the structure as a whole, we can separate out the different face types. The red pentagons look like a squashed dodecahedron, but the faces are all slightly askew. The intersections are not quite parallel to the pentagon edges. The triangles and pentagrams are also twisted slightly. The yellow snub triangles are much more complicated. The vertex configuration for the small snub Icosicosidodecahedron is 5 triangles and a pentagram. This is the same clockwise and anti-clockwise, so this is one of the few snubs that are mirror symmetric, and it doesn't have the twistedness of most snub polyhedra. Its strangest feature is that it has coplanar faces. The red triangles exist in pairs, overlapping each other, although one is twisted relative to the other, so they form hexagrams. The relative rotation is not exactly 60 degrees, so the hexagrams are irregular. I find these coplanar faces a little bit disconcerting, and I'm tempted to argue that it's not a valid polyhedron. Its dual has coinciding vertices, which seems even more unsatisfactory. But all authorities seem to accept these, so perhaps the objection is merely aesthetic. The non-snub faces of this shape all lie on the surface, and the snub triangles only dip a little beneath the surface, so it's only just concave. This figure is very reminiscent of a compound of left and right-handed snubs, for example the snub dodecahedron. But of course this separates back into 2 polyhedra, whereas the small snub Icosicosidodecahedron cannot be separated. It's as if left-handed and right-handed versions became mixed up somehow. However, it is possible to divide the non-snub triangles into 2 sets, let's say red and blue, like this. If we treat red and blue triangles as different, we now have a chiral snub polyhedron, going blue-red-orange around each vertex. Separating face types again reveals a very complicated interlacing of the snub triangles. The inverted snub dodecadodecahedron is one of my favourites. The large pentagrams on the surface are very slightly cut by other faces, making it look as if some miscalculations occurred in drawing it. You can see from the vertex figure that the pentagrams actually face inwards. This is what the inverted in its name means. Also from the vertex figure, notice how the pentagon at the bottom of the figure is barely visible because it's almost edge-on to the camera. This shows that it passes close to the centre of the polyhedron. The pentagons are mostly hidden inside the figure. This figure has only five faces around each vertex. It has three snub triangles, like all snub polyhedra, but only two non-snub faces. So snub triangles are adjacent at some edges. You can think of the third non-snub face as being a digon rather than being missing. Separation of face types shows just how close to the centre the pentagons are. This is another polyhedron with overlapping faces. The pentagrams come in coplanar pairs. There are in fact two different types of pentagram here, as half of them are retrograde. I've coloured the forward pentagrams light blue and the backward ones dark blue. Separating the faces shows the elegant arrangement of pentagrams of each type, with each pentagram arm resting against another pentagram. As you can see, in isolation, the two types of pentagram are actually the same. It's only their relationship to the triangles that distinguishes between the forwards and backwards pentagrams. This means that if we take the mirror reflection of the snub and non-snub triangles only, we can reassemble the polyhedron to find its mirror image. The light blue pentagrams, previously forwards, are now backwards, and the dark blue ones are now forwards. The great inverted snub icosidodecahedron is similar to the great snub icosidodecahedron, the only difference being that the pentagram is inverted in its vertex configuration. It is also similar to the previous figure, the great snub dodecicosidodecahedron, but has one of the pentagrams missing from its vertex configuration. Another way to explore the structure of these polyhedra is to explode them, moving each face away from the centre. As with all these snubs, note the relatively simple arrangement of the non-snub triangles and pentagrams compared with the more chaotic distribution of the snub triangles. The small retrosnub icosicosidodecahedron is closely related to the small snub icosicosidodecahedron we met earlier, although the external appearance of the two is very different. Both have exactly the same faces around each vertex, but in the retrosnub, the faces encircle the vertex twice, making the strange vertex figure. They have the same number of faces, vertices and edges. They are both mirror symmetric, and both have coplanar triangles forming non-regular hexagrams. With so many faces tightly wrapped around each vertex, this has an incredible density of 38. If you were trapped inside a small retrosnub icosicosidodecahedral prison, you'd have to break through 38 walls to escape. The penultimate figure is the great retrosnub icosidodecahedron, an elaborate combination of 92 faces meeting in 150 edges and 60 vertices. The exploded figure has 12 pink pentagrams arranged as the vertices of an icosahedron and 20 purple triangles as its faces, but all rotated slightly. The yellow snub triangles fit between the pink and purple faces, also rotated slightly. It's a half-ordered, half-chaotic jumble of faces, and yet, when they're allowed to collapse back again, each edge of each face manages, against all reasonable expectation, to marry up with precisely one other edge to form this exquisite polyhedron. It's closely related to the great snub icosidodecahedron, having the same faces around each vertex, but wrapping around twice. If we zoom in, we can see some of the fine detail. A lot of its faces pass very close to the centre, so it has a high density, 37. It also has some exceptionally sharp edges. Master polyhedron modeller Magnus Wenninger estimated 100 hours to build a cardboard model of this. I suspect that's an underestimate. And finally, we have uniform polyhedron number 75, the great Dirhombicosidodecahedron, also known as Miller's Monster, after J.C.P. Miller, although I don't know if Miller himself discovered it. This figure is the exception to almost every rule. It has 8 faces at each vertex. No other uniform polyhedron has more than 6. There are 4 squares alternating with other faces. In this sense, it's a bit like a snub, but with squares instead of triangles. The squares all pass through the centre, so it's a hemipolyhedron. The vertex figure is mirror symmetric, so the polyhedron itself is mirror symmetric. It has more faces and more edges than any other non-prismatic uniform polyhedron. And its Euler characteristic is a bizarre minus 56. All faces come in coplanar pairs. The hexagrams, made of triangle pairs, are clearly irregular. The decagrams, double pentagrams, are almost but not quite regular. But it's not just its size that makes it a monster. In their famous paper of 1954, Concerto and his colleagues employed a technique using spherical triangles and kaleidoscopes to generate the other 74 uniform polyhedra, and proved that there are only 74 such polyhedra. However, Miller's monster is a different beast entirely, related to spherical quadrilaterals rather than triangles. It must have tormented the authors. Was it a unique anomaly? Or might there be other monsters lurking out there? They hunted for a second monster, or a proof that there was no such thing, for 2 decades before giving up. There's a hint of desperation in their words in the paper's conclusion. We can only say that higher spherical polygons would have to satisfy various conditions that are almost always incompatible. In other words, they thought their list was complete, but weren't 100% sure. The monster stayed on their backs for another 2 decades, until the list was finally proved complete in the 1970s. As ever, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.